Hi and welcome to the session. I am Shashi and I am going to help you with the following question. Question says, find the maximum value of 2x cubed minus 24x plus 107 in the interval 1, 3. Find the maximum value of the same function in closed interval minus 3, minus 1. First of all, let us understand for finding absolute maximum or absolute minimum values of function f in closed interval AB. First of all, we will find all critical points of function f in the interval AB. Now, we will find value of function f at all critical points and at the end points of the given interval. Now identify the maximum and minimum values of function f out of the values which we have calculated in step 2. The maximum value of function f is absolute maximum value of function f and minimum value will be the absolute minimum value of function f. This is the key idea to solve the given question. Now let us start the solution. Let function f is given by fx equal to 2x cube minus 24x plus 107. Now differentiating both sides with respect to x, we get f dash x equal to 6x square minus 24. We know derivative of 2x cube is equal to 6x square and derivative of 24x is 24 and derivative of 107 is 0. So we get f dash x equal to 6x square minus 24. Now for finding critical points, we will put f dash x equal to 0. Now this implies 6x square minus 24 is equal to 0. We know f dash x is equal to 6x square minus 24. Now adding 24 on both sides, we get 6x square is equal to 24. Now dividing both sides by 6, we get x square is equal to 4. Now taking square root on both sides, we get x is equal to plus minus 2. Now we know we have to find the maximum value of function f in the closed interval 1, 3. And clearly we can see x equal to minus 2 does not belong to the closed interval 1, 3. So we shall not find the value of function f at x equal to minus 2. Now we will find the value of function f at x equal to 1, at x equal to 2 and at x equal to 3. Let us first of all find out f1. F1 is equal to 2 multiplied by 1 cube minus 24 multiplied by 1 plus 107. Now on simplifying we get 2 minus 24 plus 107 which is further equal to 85. So we get f1 equal to 85. Now let us find out f2. F2 is equal to 2 multiplied by 2 cube minus 24 multiplied by 2 plus 107. This is equal to 16 minus 48 plus 107. Simplifying, we get F2 equal to 75. Now let us find out F3. F3 is equal to 2 multiplied by 3 cube minus 24 multiplied by 3 plus 107. This is equal to 54 minus 72 plus 107. On simplifying, we get F3 equal to 89. Now this completes the second step of the key idea. Now we will identify maximum value. Clearly we can see maximum value of function f is 89, which occurs at x equal to 3. So we can write maximum value of 2x cubed minus 24x plus 107 in closed interval 1, 3 is 89, that occurs at x equal to 3. Now second part of the question is, find the maximum value of the same function in closed interval minus 3, minus 1. Now we know critical points of the given function are plus 2 and minus 2. Now we know 2 does not belong to closed interval minus 3, minus 1. So we will not find the value of function f at x equal to 2. Now we will find the value of function f at x equal to minus 3, at x equal to minus 2, and at x equal to minus 1. So let us find out f minus 3, that is equal to 2 multiplied by minus 3 cube minus 24 multiplied by minus 3 plus 107. Now this is equal to minus 54 plus 72. Plus 107. Now simplifying, we get f minus 3 equal to 125. Now we will find f minus 2, which is equal to 2 multiplied by minus 2 cube minus 24 multiplied by minus 2 plus 107. This is equal to minus 16 plus 48 plus 107. Simplifying, we get 139 equal to f minus 2. Now let us find out f minus 1, which is equal to 2 multiplied by minus 1 cube minus 24 multiplied by minus 1 plus 107. Now this is equal to minus 2 plus 24 plus 107. Simplifying, we get f minus 1 equal to 129. Now clearly we can see maximum value of function f is equal to 139, which occurs at x equal to minus 2. So we can write maximum value of 2x cubed minus 24x plus 107 in closed interval minus 3 minus 1 is 139, that occurs at x equal to minus 2. So this is our required answer. This completes the session. Hope you understood the solution. Have a nice day.